West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider, no you don't want nada.
Yo, what the fuck, dude?
Hey.
What the hell? The hell's even up?
Dude.
Chilling, man. Dude.
Nothing.
You probably noticed I'm all mushed out right now.
You're mushed out, dude.
Yeah, a bro off IG, a Hawaiian mushroom company, sent me a bunch of shit, so I got it from the P.O. box right before I left.
Enough said.
A lot of lion's mane and shit. I'm on, Brittany was pissed because I took like all the different mushroom powders at once and left. She was like, that's ridiculous. That shirt's too, everything. She was hating on everything I was doing. I took all the different mushroom powders.
Yeah.
She was like, you don't need that much. I was like, watch me. She's like, that shirt's too big. I said, watch me.
Dude, I haven't taken.
I was Wahlberg, dude. I was.
You were the municipal, the mushies.
Municipal.
You
got
to stay prayed up, dude. Show me your underpants. Municipals.
I wish they were
sheath,
just,
dude.
Sheath, obviously.
Podcast underpants. I only wear podcast underpants.
How the freaking heck are you?
I'm doing fine. My allergies certainly kicked in this morning. Isn't and I'll tell annoying? You what, I'm none too pleased, but it could be that gas leak that's happening in my kitchen.
What? You got gas leak?
Certainly.
You think the mice's got in there?
I think the mice chewed the line because it stinks over there.
RIP to whatever mice broke through, or mouse broke through there. That's probably.
It was worth it. It was worth it to get rid of one of those fuckers.
Yeah.
Me get and my a cat. Sweet dude, niece. I can't get a cat.
I'm saying get it and then just fucking re-release it.
I could never
do that.
It's
a stray cat.
I could never do that to a sweet feline.
It's a stray cat.
I could never.
It probably wants out. Open the door. How about this? Open the door. Let it make up its own mind. If it stays, it stays. If it leaves, it leaves. You can also get a cat. You can get someone to come in here and feed your cat while you're gone. But you said the companionship, it would kill it. Yo, then get.
I'll do you one better. I'm getting five fucking cats. Strays. I want it to be chaos in here.
It would smell so bad.
It'd be nuts.
Oh my God.
There'd be shit every. I would not clean it. You ever clean a litter box? It sucks, dude.
Hold it down tough here. If one of them steps out of line,
I start beating the fuck out of cats.
Beating cats is crazy.
Yeah, kicking them.
Dude, it's nice to think about cat ladies eventually going rogue and just beating their they beat their cats.
You would when whale one of bad, them. You would whale one of them. Dude. Scratching up the couch.
Oh.
Sitting next to you.
Come back from a Tinder date, dude. The guy was way taller in his pictures. You go back to your cats. You're just fucking, fuck you.
It's never going to happen.
Darth Vader.
Darth Vader. You're mushed up, dude.
Yeah, I'm all mushed out, bro.
I had to stop taking those after my vicious after bout almost, with diarrhea. I've been afraid of them.
It might not have been that. Although, yeah, if you're on the same program.
I didn't stray from my program.
I was about to say, if you're the same program, if it was Detroit style pizza.
Yeah.
Yeah, wings.
I did not, yeah.
Maybe the mushies got in there and were like, what the hell's going on here?
Perhaps.
Get out.
Perhaps.
Evacuate. Dude, I had the most fucked up stomach all week. I don't know what I did. I set myself up for failure this week and I gotta look into that. But like, dude, I did the heaviest workout with the fucking DBs.
Yeah.
I went with the Disgusting Brothers and did a leg workout, which yeah. Dude, those two working out is one of my favorite it's things awesome. To think about.
Dude, did you see Spud?
He's looking yoked, bro.
No, I mean,
oh, his fucking face? His
face and arm and shit?
Yeah, he fell, dude. He fucking busted his face up. what do you want from the guy?
He looks nuts, dude. He came in wounded yesterday. They did Stuff Island last night.
Yeah, he glued his face together.
Yeah.
He split his face in the middle of the night and it's glued it together, went back to bed.
Glued it and put a neon bandage on his face. Yeah, I know. His arm's just mangled.
He ate it, dude.
He just says he slipped.
Anyone, dude, any of us can fall like that.
I don't think, dude.
Any of us can fucking eat it like that. He took a Biden tumble.
He said middle of the night, he got up and his socks hit the fucking hardwood floor. And he fell forward.
Do you think he was taking care of business?
I don't know what he was doing. I think that looked like a Brewski tumble to me.
It did look like a Brewski.
But apparently he didn't include that there was Brewskis involved.
No Brewskis. Yeah, I didn't ask. I was a gentleman about it. I was like,
I didn't ask either. But that's definitely a Brewski fault. Dude, you can't just walk to the kitchen and shatter your face and arm.
There's usually a chipped tooth involved as well. Yeah. But no, he explained it to me that he had something with his hands and he like just fully swan dives right into the fucking floor.
I mean, I get it. If tumble. It's pitch black.
Yeah, true.
Falling must be crazy.
He fell through the void, dude.
Yeah.
He felt the fucking grunt.
I'm trying to think of the last time I fell because it is funny.
Last time I ate
falling
it?
Down is funny as hell.
I haven't eaten it. I can't think of the last time I fully. Oh, dude, I fucking ate it. I ate it recently.
I remember the last time I fell. Hold on, I was hammered at JFK. I fell in the bathroom.
No. You took a Brewski tumble?
I took a Brewski tumble at JFK, dude. Oh, look. It gets worse. I took a Brewski tumble upon arrival. I went to Buffalo Wild Wings at arrival and got hammered. Me and O'Connor were like arguing. Me and O'Connor got shit-faced.
Wait, you were arriving at the airport?
At a Buffalo Wild Wings in JFK.
You couldn't
upon
wait?
Upon arrival.
What the hell?
I think there was some NBA on.
Let's just
catch the fourth quarter and then we'll go home.
I see.
Had a couple of brewskis, started arguing. I think I was mid-argument with him and then I went to the bathroom and he was walking in as I was still laying on the ground. And I was like, this doesn't change anything, dude. You're still wrong. It ends the argument of me. If you slip at the bathroom at JFK, your life is meaningless. Dude.
You're over.
You're the biggest loser.
I'm surprised you could get up. Lesser men would have stayed there, dude.
Like a fucking Everest climber.
Like a bar. You're like a fucking shell on the hull of the boat, dude.
Oh, dude.
It's like a barnacle. Dude. You just lay there.
It's killing
me.
I'm sorry.
Nah. Dude, I took the... quite possibly the lamest tumble the other night. I was going up. It was like, you know, I always shut all the lights out. I like to walk up in the pitch black. Well, you know, relatively dark. In my first floor, there's still like light coming through the windows. But I'm carrying my nightly glass of water up and I go to like turn the blinds.
My nightly glass of water.
I can't sleep without water. Next I know. So I get my nightly glass. It's the fucking vessel, dude.
You need a glass of water.
Yeah, but it's the nightly glass.
It's different than your nightly glass.
it's different than any other glass. The nightly glass hits so much different.
Oh, yes.
So I have it, dude. And it's like, sometimes I sip a little like on the way up and have to like turn around. I'm like, dude, that's my nightly glass. I need to flip the brim. So I'm like sitting there, I'm carrying it. And I fucking go to twist the blinds to close them. And I tumbled, just like safely fell on my couch, which just spilled the water all over me. Like, no, oh, fuck. It was such a nerd tumble. It was fully like, again, no injuries whatsoever. I just tripped on my couch like, nah. And there were seconds of water just hit me. I was like, dude, I fucking suck so bad.
Yeah.
In a dark room, just fucking wet. Just like
covered in water. It was great.
Yeah.
Oh, great. Now I have to dry off before bed. Great.
I went right up and told my babe. I said, you probably love this because you fucking hate me.
Yeah.
But I fucking
you would enjoy this.
You would have loved to have seen me fucking fall.
I was
like
just
that.
Embarrassed alone. Which is hard to do.
Yeah, I'd rather have you cackling at me at my fucking expense because you love to see me fail.
Dude, if you got hit by a car, they'd have to they love it. My woman here would remember cheering against me in UFC?
Yep.
What?
What the hell?
Support me.
Yeah, dude, especially.
Especially in the octagon. Dude.
Yeah, dude, people get hurt.
Lemeezy, I just took some aggression out on you, dude. You just got punished, brother.
What are you mad at?
No, I'm not mad at you. No, I do hate you.
I think
he's
mad at your outrageous claims that you can lift 265 pounds bench press.
Yeah, with no warm up, yeah.
Dude, we're fucking lifting heavy. That would have been fine like a year ago to talk about that. We wouldn't have cared. But now
me
like,
and Matt have been lifting heavy. You should have seen me yesterday, dude.
Don't fucking talk.
You couldn't even imagine what I was doing yesterday.
Yeah, lifting.
I don't
weights.
Even know what they're called.
What?
It's doing like you gotta spread your legs with and hold a kettlebell in between and do go like side to side lunges on each leg.
Damn,
it's fucking impossible, dude.
How much you do with that? 1,000 pounds?
Easily. Easy. That's what. This is how it all started. Me and Ahmed lifted, and he in the green room before the show. He's just like, "Did you guys lift?" And we're like, "Yeah." And he goes, "Who lifted more?" And just immediately made it a competition. And then
it's not a competition either, Lemaire.
Just immediately. He's just standing there, didn't lift, just standing there, and he's like, I could lift more. I was like, dude, why are you doing this to me? Why are you getting me going?
Trying to have
like
a fun time.
Yeah.
You put a bug in your crawl.
And then as soon as we got done saying it, he's like, no, you started it. And I was like, God damn it.
Wow.
I can do it though. I can.
265.
Yeah.
One rep max.
Yep.
We can settle this tomorrow, dude.
We can settle it right now. Yeah. I told my trainer yesterday about it.
Load him up.
And I said, can we go into that gym tomorrow so Lemaire can bench 265? He said, yes.
Let's go.
He also said he didn't believe in you. I said, the guy hasn't benched in probably a decade, and he claims 265 just, he knows it in
what'd
his
the
soul.
What'd the trainer say?
He laughed. He said, that's very funny. He said, ha, 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 ha.
It's crazy that he just underestimated me because I'm a freak, dude. I'll do it.
You're a freak?
I'm a freak, dude.
Why are you saying you're a freak?
Because I'm a freak.
Yeah, but what the evidence? You can't just say I'm a freak.
True. That's a good point.
Oh, this was, you know, dude, this was making me laugh so hard. We were driving. We were going to the Reds batting practice. And Lemaire was like, I play a little baseball. I was like, dude, you told me about your baseball career. Don't. I think he forgot he told me. It was so funny. It's my favorite story about Lemaire. He quit. He just walked off the field.
Oh yeah, you left your position.
just walked straight home. Just standing in the outfield playing with bugs. Just like, you know what? It's time for some Street Fighter pizza rolls. I'm walking straight off the field.
That's crazy, dude.
Legendary.
Because you were saying you got to go in there if they like.
Oh
get
yeah, we were
up.
Saying yeah. I was like, if at BP they're like, I'd be like, dude, can we get one pitch?
Yeah,
I just want to feel. I just want to see it.
God.
You have to if you're there.
Did they give it to you?
No, I had no understanding of batting practice.
What'd they do?
No, it's fully. It's just T-ball? Two major league baseball teams. They're not just letting dudes out on the field. I got there. I was like, I'm a fucking moron that I thought this was.
You thought there's a guy being like, all right, center left.
Yeah.
Heads up, second base.
They actually do that.
Do they really?
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Guys like just slowly field balls. Yeah. It was pause. It was awesome though. It was awesome.
Batting practice would be sick.
Yeah.
HRD would be nice too. A little nice. HRD.
Got to see Votto hit some BP. Lemaire left a minute before we got in. As soon as you walked away, they were like, all right. Well, that did suck though. That sucked. We were standing outside for like an hour. And just outside the stadium. It was the one day it was 90 degrees in Cincinnati. Oh. Just standing there getting cooked. It was tough.
So you took off and you didn't get into the stadium?
No, I took a scoot to the game store.
Freak.
You walked away from the game again. You walked away from the game again for the second time in your life. He was walking away from the game. Why did you walk away from the game, dude?
Keep walking in the cornfield, disappearing.
It's not my game, dude. It's not my game.
What's your game? Bench press is your game, dude.
Powerlifting.
By the way, you are built to be a perfect powerlifter.
You could
squat 9,000 pounds, dude.
No, dude, I could totally do the 265. I'm not even worried about it.
You do have short arms.
Short arms, big chest. He is strong.
Yeah, I know.
Undeniably strong.
No doubt.
But I just don't. I don't love the confidence having no. I don't think you've ever done it.
Listen, 265. I don't know if I've ever. No, I've never tried to max out though.
Yeah, but when's the last time you benched? That's the only thing that I'm.
It was the pandemic. It was at a YMCA last year.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Damn, it wasn't that bad for you.
All right. We got some. What were you doing? Do you remember?
Well, like I was doing the arm johns.
All right.
I was going knees.
This is what I'm talking about.
You're hanging from fucking walk, like crosswalk signs and doing pull-ups.
Yeah. Well, anyway, hopefully we can settle that as soon as we get done with this.
Yeah, well, yeah.
That would make me very happy. Either way, it's going to be a victory.
Yeah, it's win-win.
If he gets it, awesome. It's hilarious.
Awesome.
If he doesn't get it, I'm going to squeal in his face.
If he doesn't get it,
I'm not going to help him lift the bar up off his chest. So I'm going to put my face over you and go, wee, wee. I'm going to say, squeal, swine.
He'll have to live under it until he can push it up. You'll be like the lady in the coffin in Kill Bill, dude. You have to punch him right out.
Nice. Hey.
Back to us, dude.
Hey, back to the real show. So you filmed your first ever comedy special,
this
weekend.
It was awesome.
How did it go?
I think it went well. It was, I did the brutal workout the day of, I don't know, I was just like killing time. I was like, I'm going to fucking, and it was because I was doing it with Billy. So he's like, oh dude, this is going to be the hardest shit ever. So I kept being like, sorry, it's not that bad.
Just
I couldn't help but be like, this isn't that bad.
Yeah.
Like, I left and was like, Jesus fucking Christ.
Yeah.
So then, since I had lifted so much, I was like, well, I need to eat a lot. So I didn't eat much for the first show. And then that night I went out and I pigged on Mexican food and ate like the spiciest fucking hot sauce possible. And I've had this stuff before. I knew it was a little spicy. I didn't know how spicy it was. Dude, it was like, I was like hiccuping. Spicy. It was so hot.
Yeah.
Then I like fucking rubbed it. It was on a paper towel and I like went to blow my nose and it went all over my face. I was fucked up. Yeah. So I woke up. So day one went well. One show, great. Way too spicy food. Everything's fine. Woke up that morning, like spicy, like diarrhea. Yeah, true.
It's a day in the life, baby. Woke up, got out of bed, had some spicy diarrhea.
Before the second show, I ate Indian food. So my ass was, dude, I don't know why I did this myself.
I get it. But when the day, when you film a special, it's just pure panic, it's anxiety, spaz, dude.
Dude, and I was telling McKeever.
At least you did that. I went and shaved my head.
Yeah, I didn't get the haircut. Thank God.
I was just walking. I was like, I got to make some change. I got to do something right now.
I was like,
I'm going to shave my fucking head before the special.
Well, that makes sense because you want your hair to look different.
Yeah.
Different show. I get that. But yeah, dude, I was telling McKeever, I was like, my stomach, between like the food I was eating and like the adrenaline I was like, my DNA thinks it's in the fucking Crusades, dude.
Yeah.
It's just nothing but like aromatic cuisines and just pure panic and just shitting. It was crazy. The diarrhea was unbelievable. I should have documented that as the intro.
Yeah. A loud shit. This camera follow you out from a loud shit straight to stage. That'd actually be pretty sick.
That would be awesome.
Yeah.
But no, it went well, dude. It was fucking nerve-wracking, dude. The first, the day leading up to it, I was just like, fuck, dude. There's going to be so many cameras. I'm going to shit the bed just blank and be like, nope, I'm not doing this. My negative self is still strong. And it was just like, dude, what if, hear me out here, brother. What if you fucking go up there and go, camera one, camera two.
It's just the whole special. Staring straight in every camera.
I give myself no credit at all. That's
of course.
In my head, I was like, there's a 40% chance I'm going to go,
it's just, you can see the camera, you just go.
Dude, then I got out and the first show was fine. I was like, what the fuck? I'm nuts.
It's so scary.
I was for sure convinced I was gonna go, what is this? This is the mic for the crowd.
Take all your clothes off. Should have a full mental breakdown. I even talking about it right now is giving me the willies.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I got like two more weeks.
At least you've been through it before, though.
Not like this one.
Yeah, true.
It was a theater with big cameras. cameras. I'm just gonna go.
Even more so, dude. Oh.
Yeah, with the YouTube, I felt like...
How many levels is this theater?
Woo, that's big.
How many people here again? Oh, that's like the size of my high school.
So many, fucking 10 times the size of my high school.
Shit.
Yeah, it's one of the worst feelings.
Yeah, it stunk. I was
And like, you experienced the blues a little after the post special blues. Yeah. Dude. At least you were. I had to sit by myself.
Yeah, that would have been weird.
It was very, very weird.
Yeah, that would have been crazy. I did have a touch of sweetness though. I had on the, I did a 4:30 p.m. show. And Maya got to come to that, so yeah. That was, dude. She got to chill backstage and just watching the cameras. And dude, right before I went on, so I was like, she came. It was like Gardini was about to go up. She came back and she was like, she loves the idea of being at my work. She's like, I'm at Daddy's work. She loves it.
Oh.
So she came back. She's looking at the like the little monitors and stuff.
Yeah.
And then I said something to her, and she was like, you're funny, Daddy. And I was like, thank you.
Oh,
I was going to cry, dude. She killed me.
I would have cried.
I know. She killed me.
I almost cried on stage this weekend.
What happened?
My uncle died.
Oh.
And then towards the end of my set, the first, I found out that day, like before the show, and I was on stage, and I was like, in my head, while they're laughing and clapping, I was like, he was so proud of me.
Oh.
And there was just a part where I was like, just looked at a camera. Anyway, I should have brought that up.
Yeah, no, that's
your daughter saying that is, but then so fucking
this was the worst. I came off because she was only there for a little bit and left to get dinner, so I came off and I was like, yeah, that one was all right. I mean, I'm just going like full psycho talk, and I'm like, after like 5 minutes, I'm like, hey, where's Maya? And Brittany's like, you're just fucking realizing right now. I was like, yeah, all right, come on. I'm fucking coming in. I'm coming in from another fucking, I had to like step down and back in the stratosphere, bro. But yeah, dude, it was my parents came to one of the shows. That was really nice. They haven't seen me do stand up for like probably 12 years.
Ooh.
So they came.
Big jump.
Yeah, that was, yeah. So they got my dad got stopped at the door. He brought a gun and a knife on him. The show. He had the hawk on him and that thing. He had a hawk and a toast on him. Yeah, he was like, because I saw my mom. I'm like, oh, where's dad? She's like, he's back in the car.
I know why. I'm not going into the city.
Dude, he came back in the city, dude. He came up like Bayou Billy, dude.
Going into the city, you need to bring a gun.
If you've
been outside the city for a while.
Dude, having the hawk is so funny. The gun, he had a 9mm on him and then a knife. Like, fire his last shot.
What'd they say? Yeah.
Yeah.
What'd they say?
They were like, dude, they metal detector. They do the wand. God bless you.
Thanks, bro.
They do the wand, and they wanded him. They were like, dude, you have the hawk and the toast on you? He's like, yeah.
So I didn't think those things worked.
Oh, yeah. Apparently, yeah, they got him. I told him, I'm like, dude, next time, let me know. I'll let you in the back if you want to keep that thing on.
Yeah, if you need the handgun during my special. You could be, it'd be like Manchester by the Sea if you bombed.
True.
Get off stage and just take it out of his holster.
That was my best show, the one they were at. That was sweet.
That was the one I was most worried for you.
I know, me too.
As soon as I heard a bunch of your family was coming,
oh, they were,
I was
they
like,
were at a, they were sprinkled through.
You're fucking this thing up,
dude. There was parts of there. My whole family was there on the one night, on the one show, like my cousins and stuff.
Yeah.
There was one show I did where like I was sitting there on stage and I'd be blah blah blah. Then I'd look out and be like, oh, there's one of my neighbors. And I talk, and I'd be like, oh, there's a guy I went to high school with.
Yeah.
And it was just, I started getting like spun out. I was just like, what the fuck's going on here?
Yeah, that's tough.
It went well, though. It went well. We did, you know, we recorded a bunch, and I'm excited. I'm trying not to be a big baby and be like, can I see it now? Can I see it now, please? Can I please?
Oh, yeah.
I'm waiting. They said tomorrow or Wednesday, so I'm like, that's fine.
I do this thing where if I see someone in the crowd, I just convince myself it's somebody I know. I'm like, oh, that's that guy. And the whole show, I'm like, it's just the one guy. And then the lights come on at the end. I'm like, that was not that guy. That was not even close to that guy. I did that. Oh, fuck. Who was it? I was convinced it was like a famous actress.
Really?
And the whole time I was like, holy shit, I can't believe she's here. Dude, I thought it was like, for real, I don't remember who it was. I thought it was like a Meryl Streep level.
God damn.
Famous actress in the front row,
oh,
the whole
so
show.
Funny.
I was like, just looking at a woman that was like, what?
That's hilarious. Yeah, yeah, I had the opposite. It was like one of my friends from high school. I was kind of like, is that him? And I was like, that looks just like, and I was like, wait a second here.
It is him.
Yeah, it was
well,
cool.
Cool.
It was a cool experience, man. I'm glad I'm through it. I'm done with it.
Yeah.
So that's a pretty, I could have seen myself never doing that, you know, just wondering.
Yeah, you should. You had to do that.
Yeah, you have to. But yeah, I'm glad. It was nice too. I had to like think about how to talk and everything. I just am like, blah, 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 and I was like, oh fuck, you have to talk clearly.
Yeah.
Shit. So that was it. Just mine and my mannerisms and stuff.
Mannerisms. Is,
my hands. So I'm like, yeah. This. I do this a lot. I think I go.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. <it's>, yeah.
I like it.
That was pretty much it, dude. But yeah, Sean, you should have seen Sean, dude. Hero of the weekend.
The guard dog.
Dude, he had to do like...
What a legend.
12 or 13, complete ledge. No, no, no. 12 to 13 up front. House. I didn't know what the house lights were. I didn't know meant all the lights were on in the room. I thought it was just like a little light.
Yeah.
That like, you know, you could lower. Gardini was doing 12 minutes up front, cold audience, totally lit room.
Why? Why were the house lights on?
It was like, McKeever had this idea that like you keep him up, and then when I went on, because it was like announcement, and then it dropped, the lights would, that way it would like... There was going to be a gap between Sean and me for like filming purpose, some sort of filming purpose. So then like he was like, the lights will drop and then that'll signify to the audience. So I was like, yeah, that sounds cool to me. I thought they were like dim and then dimmer.
Yeah.
Gardini was out there in the blistering fucking heat.
Oh my
dude.
God.
Dude. And then after I got everybody. Done, he had to come out and do the check spot.
Oh my.
So I got done. I mean, I was a total prima donna.
No, you were.
I was a total prima donna.
It was
all
your
week.
Special night.
Sure. It was my special night.
I was
night.
Happy
sure.
to help.
My night's up. But dude, he was out there just. People would stand up.
I was fighting.
I had to watch him do it like 5 times.
Yeah.
Me and Noah sang the national anthem, though. That yeah. was the one nice
That's
time.
That's pretty sick.
Yeah. And I yeah. came out. I came out to the very end. I came out, That's brothers nice. In arms. And I was like, oh, I'll come out with you. Almost left him out to dry. I was like, yeah. saw him out there. I was like, man, I'm a little tired. I don't feel like going back out there.
Yeah.
And I said, yeah, I can't leave
you
him.
You went
like
back,
that.
Dude.
I said, I can't leave him.
Like Barcelona.
Yeah. No, we went out. It was fun. We had a little, yeah, we had some talk. Some guy was saying, he's like, dude, I fucking, I got my kid. I didn't get my kid circumcised because you said it was bad. And then like 3 weeks later, you said it. Maybe it's not that bad of an idea. I was like, you can always wait, dude.
Great.
Yeah, I was like, you can always wait. You know, you don't have to do it right now. I told him, I'm like, if you catch him masturbating, take him right to the hospital and fucking cut his fucking skin off.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
Just mutilate him.
Trans him.
True. Back and forth. How many times do you think you can trans back and forth before you die?
Probably like twice, dude. That's
you think you can only do it twice?
It's a pretty vicious surgery.
True.
Yeah.
Imagine getting reunited with it. Can you freeze your dong just in case?
No,
I think you have to turn it inside out to
yeah.
make a vagina. Dude,
it's like sauerkraut.
Mr. Garrison, that's a cartoon, Sean. We're talking about real fucking life and real Sean, we're talking about real Americans.
We're talking about real Americans, dicks and pussies. We're
talking about our United States military.
Speaking of the military. Shout out to the SEALs. Let's go. They
how
came the, through.
How those mainland SEALs versus the West Coast SEALs?
They're good. They're the sniper boys.
Ooh.
Extra scary.
Prairie fellas.
Yeah. No, they were. That's just where the training is. They're from all over.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. But it was good. Good time. Good hang.
Dude, can I float a theory by you?
I'd love to hear it.
So Noah was at Pride Parade. His business, his life. I don't even care. It's whatever. He was at Pride Parade.
He was just walking
around.
What were you doing there?
I was walking through. I was walking home from my girlfriend's, and I said, I'll check this out.
Yeah.
Walking home from your girlfriend's?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what's his name?
So Noah's walking through, and he was saying
got that,
that
one from the snipers.
He said there's a lot of naked people, right?
There was a few naked people.
Naked people. Lemaire said he walked through as well.
Obviously.
And he said he was getting raging hard-ons. But he was saying that there was...
Wait.
I said there's naked ladies.
Because of the babes.
He's choosing.
Okay.
He? Yeah, there's babes.
And you got a boner walking through?
Dude, I was fucking boned up.
You could have popped the floats, dude.
Yeah,
so
Lemeezy
was saying there's a bunch of black lesbians.
Black lesbians.
Black lesbians there. Were they on a float, Lemaire, or they were just posted up together?
They were just posted up.
Oh, yeah, the black lesbians were just posted. Big, big old black... Posted up, dude, on the corner.
Dude, Noah, man.
Christ,
what the hell?
Noah,
can
it's
you
PC.
Please?
It's PC. My friends are lesbians.
Dude, Jesus
it's okay.
Christ, Noah.
Yeah.
Studs is the preferred term.
Studs. Actually, I do think in the African-American community, it is fairly okay to...
True.
To say the D word, I would never.
Yeah, true. Jesus Christ, no.
That's not a word I use, even off
stud.
Mic.
I actually prefer studs phonetically.
Studs is nice.
Well, here's my theory. My theory is that, so Lemaire said there was a bunch of studs, black lesbians, catcalling, white ladies, pogs, basically, fat ass white ladies.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Pretty awesome. The theory I floated to Lemaire, and he seems to be in agreement. I don't know what's in his heart, but I'm saying that black lesbians, on the terms of the cool hierarchy, are neck and neck with white guys, straight white men. I would say straight white men and black lesbians are just as cool as each other. And I think black lesbians hate that fact.
And black guys are the coolest?
They're cooler than us and black lesbians, yes, I'd say. For the time being.
True.
For the time being.
Till we rise
all
up.
Empires fall. All empires
true.
Fall.
True.
All empires
fall.
There
are cracks in the empire right now.
Oh, dude, yeah.
You
for
can
sure.
See it.
For sure. For sure.
It's time for the white people to become cool.
We could. I mean, I don't know. I mean,
we've done it before.
Yeah, dude, we will be back. But yeah, I think that would be a contentious point if you were to meet a stud and bring that up, but I think it's the absolute truth.
In the hierarchy of coolness, you're saying us and black lesbians are tied?
I think we're neck and neck. I honestly, to be fair, I might be kind of, you know, a bit partial ourselves, but I think we're a little bit above them.
I don't know. Every black lesbian I'm friends with is cool.
Yeah, but I think they try too hard to be cool. Cool just emanates off us easier. In my opinion, I saw it. I was there. Me and Brittany were out eating the one night, and it was just studs. It was a studdle date, dude. It was two studs with their babe.
It was stud love.
And dude, Brittany kept getting mad at me because I kept like anything they were doing. I kept trying to copy their manner. And I was like, they're trying too hard. I was like, they're trying too hard. I'm just swagged out. I'm naturally swagged out. I think the swag.
You are naturally swagged.
Yeah, I think there's force. I think they're forcing the swag. A little bit. I have nothing against them.
Lesbians?
I think they're cool. They're cooler than Asian dudes. They're cooler than Asian dudes.
White lesbians might be dead last. They are fucking brutal, dude.
You knocked the wind out of me with that, dude.
They might be dead last. How about Indians making a run lately?
Yeah.
Indian dudes are making a run, dude.
Yeah.
They're cool. They're cool.
Yeah. They're cool. They're coming from. I mean,
Indian dudes. I'm talking legit guys. The Indian. Yeah. My life. My attitude. Those guys. My rules. That guy's awesome.
Yeah, I mean, right now things were locked in place. Now things are kind of like
Muhammad. Muslims are gaining on me too.
Really?
I like that stuff.
Well, they all love Andrew Tate now. Muslims all love Andrew Tate, including
Muhammad.
I like
it. A lot with Islam. I'm starting to come around.
What happened?
Obviously, Catholicism is the one true religion.
What were you guys talking about?
Just, never mind. No, I'm not. You know, how Muhammad married a six-year-old. That was, once I had a couple drinks, I was reminding him that
you guys were debating,
the prophet married a six-year-old.
Were you guys debating figureheads of your respective religions, though?
Yes. He was calling, he opened with Catholics are pedophiles. I said, brother.
Yeah.
Google Aisha. You two, or Google Muhammad, Aisha. Aisha was the six-year-old that Muhammad married.
You think that was kind of like layaway?
Till she was nine, I think.
What?
But I don't know.
Nine?
That's neither here nor there. I forgot about that part. That was nasty. Other than that, I really like Islam.
Yeah.
We were drinking. We were doing car bombs. Gotcha ass. Dude, I've been fucking you up. Car bombs. He never admits that I beat him in car bombs. This was just, had to do it to him. Then he started playing the basketball game at the bar.
What happened?
Had to do it to
what?
Him.
What?
I was just dominating.
No, dude. No. I won the game. You got more points, though. I won the first game.
The second game,
he got more points. The second game.
Wait, you won
we were
the
just
first
seeing
game.
Who could get the high score. You played three rounds. I played two. I got the high score.
Yeah.
You couldn't beat it. You choked, dude. You had it. He had it. He had it. It was so easy. I've never seen someone choke. He missed his last 10 shots.
Was this before you guys went and bench press and came back and he's like, I can lift more weights than you guys?
This was probably after that. This probably started the you in every single thing.
Yeah, that's what I think happened.
Yeah. The car bomb was the night before, but then the basketball was the next day.
I can admit defeat to the car bomb. It was my first time losing.
I'm surrounded by nincompoops.
So you opened your eyes to them. What did you like about the Muslim faith?
I just liked saying, Allahu Akbar.
That shit's fucking
sick. That was fun.
Praying, what is it, five times a day?
That's a little much.
That shit, I think it rules. It's a smoke break. They basically build in a smoke break.
Yeah.
I used to work with a Muslim guy who used to lay down on pizza boxes and do that.
But hearing the call to prayer, if you lived in one of those cities, hearing that song five times a day would get a little...
Yeah, but imagine if you were just chilling. It was like, on eagle's wings. You're wake. You're like just opening your eyes like, oh, fuck.
Yeah.
This is fucking sweet.
That is nice.
It's kind of nice.
And he
I am the lord of the dance city. And you're like,
yo.
Oh, shit, dude. It's fucking lit, dude. It's 7 a.m. It's already so fucking lit.
It is lit.
They're probably like singing those songs on those speakers are probably like, she had fabulous green eyes and was mysterious. She was so mysterious. She was my...
I don't think they're that creative in their
uncle's
songs.
Uncle's friend.
I think, I think it's just like, God is great over and over
again.
It's
something about the one that got away.
You think?
Yeah. I want to see the father.
My life, my rules, my attitude. Yeah, I think Indian dudes are making a run.
May her butter bucket always be full.
Yeah, it's just gibberish crap.
It's so funny making fun of different people, dude.
Obviously, dude. I know. It doesn't get old.
It's so fun, though.
God, it's fun.
It's such a funny joke. It does suck because, you know, obviously there are people who are... We're basically like, you know, there are people who are like fluid about sexuality. We're just fluid about like everything else.
Yeah.
Like some people would hear this and be like, that's not funny.
Yeah.
That's us they're talking. We don't have butter buckets.
How do they know about the fucking butter buckets? How did they find out about our precious butter buckets?
I think most people can just be like, oh, obviously it's a joke, but there's definitely people that are locked in, unfortunately, who are going, they're not allowed to do that.
I get it.
That's against the rules.
No, I kind of get it. Everybody, yeah. When they come for you, then it's like, wait a second.
Yeah, but if it's funny, I'll take it.
Sure.
But yeah, maybe people don't appreciate that, though. We don't have songs about the girl who got away. She wasn't my uncle's friend.
Yeah, do they
change?
I don't think this song changes.
I don't think so.
I think it's the same call to prayer every time, right?
It's just like Beatles covers. Really?
Elvis.
In a caliphate.
We all... Yeah, it's tough to do. It's tough to get off that.
I might start exploring. Yeah, you can slide something in.
Yeah.
Can't touch this.
Can't touch this. They do need to switch up the song. Lollipop would be so sick.
Lollipop would be net.
Every day, 5 a.m. Bim, 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 bim. I am the candy man.
That's
close.
So nasty. You think it's the same song every morning? Like the
I believe it is. In my heart of hearts, I believe. It's the exact same song five times
awesome
a day.
It's how awesome is
every
our God.
Single
how
day.
How awesome is our God.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, dude, that's...
Until you hear that fortunate son coming, if you guys... Every once in a while, the song stops, and you hear... Bang, down, down. You're like, God damn it, we got oil.
Some folks are bone. Yeah, true. I forgot that comes.
What else is going on? What else is going on?
If you haven't found the perfect Father's Day gift yet, don't panic. Your old man just wants to look sharp. Help him out with Manscaped. Shave his penis for him. Manscaped Performance Package 4.0 is everything dad needs to get grooming. The package includes the Lawnmower 4.0 trimmer, Weed Whacker 2.0, ear and nose and hair trimmer, crop preserver, ball deodorant, crop reviver, toner, and performance boxer briefs. Wow.
Whoa.
Everything comes in a classy travel bag, making it easy to gift. I mean, there's nothing for me to say about trimming my pubes. I do it every 2 months, and I get pubes everywhere, and my wife spazzes.
I wait till it gets fully out of control.
Oh, dude, and then I hit my wife with prickly
feels
pubes.
So, how good does your penis and balls feel after you shave?
Oh, my
get
God.
Get in the shower, put some soap on it. You're like, whoa.
Yeah, I mean, just, I can't stop touching. This is my personal endorsement. I can't stop touching my smooth penis.
Yeah, once I shave my sack, I rub it
Let's
raw.
Just say it takes me back. If your dad...
Is that in there? Takes me back to when I was a youth, smashing my penis in the shower.
If your dad already has his grooming routine down, hook him up with Gay dad, hook him up with your Manscaped Boxers 2.0 or some new shower gel to get things squeaky clean. Get 20% off of free shipping with the code DRENCHED at manscaped.com. That's 20% off of free shipping at manscaped.com and use code DRENCHED. Make this Father's Day one he won't forget with Manscaped.
Fucking think about it. Guys, are you looking for the perfect Father's Day gift? How about you get him a Wi-Fi connected digital picture frame from Aura? I'm going to give Phil one with a preloaded photo of men's butts. They wrote that. That was actually really funny.
Did they write that?
Yeah, shout out Aura for that.
Good job, Aura.
Name the number one best digital picture frame by Wirecutter, The Strategist, and Wired. Aura frames are guaranteed to make dad and grandpa smile every fucking day of their shitty lives. No USB ports, no SD cards, no hassle. These frames are simple to load, simple to set up. With a free unlimited storage, you can add photos and videos from any device instantly from anywhere in the world throughout the Aura app.
Get Phil
That's
on,
so nice.
Get dudes' butts and then like just pictures of like they do on like TV of like starving children. Just starving children, dudes' butts.
If you can Wi-Fi send any of if you can send these, yes, this is actually really great. Get everyone in the family with the free app and they can send photos from the trip to Texas while you're still in fucking where you're eating barbecue. Come on. Oh my goodness, Matt! Not while I'm in the middle of this. Right now, Aura has a great deal for Father's Day. Listeners can save on the perfect gift by visiting auraframes.com/MSSP. That's auraframes.com/MSSP. Use code MSSP to get up to $30 off and free shipping on their best-selling frames. This deal ends on June 18th, so don't wait. Terms and conditions apply. Matt, if you cut the cheese one more time while I'm trying to fucking read these things, you better quit cutting cheese. Back to the show.
That was an intense.
That was crazy, dude. Wait,
I think we only had two.
One more. Yeah, Shane, we were brought to you by Bird Dog Shorts. Did you know bird dogs do the exact... do the exact same thing Lululemon yoga pants do, but for guys? What, make my pussy look fat and tempting? They invented a cloud knit fabric that looks just like khaki, but it stretches so you get a slim, sculpted look. I honestly do like Bird Dog's pants. Bird Dog's pants and shorts, I've been looking at them. I've been woefully looking at, I have Target shorts, and I've been looking at my Bird Dogs, and I'm like, man, I wish I incinerated these Target shorts and had just BD gear.
BD gear's sick.
I'm about to fucking
no diggity.
I'm gonna buy some more Bird Dogs.
Yeah.
With anti-stink sweat-wicking fabric, you'll stay cool and dry instead of hot and swampy. You can even swim in them. Bird Dog would have silenced
disgusting
that part.
Disgusting brothers.
Head to birddogs.com/drenched and enter promo code DRENCHED for a free Yeti-style tumbler with every order.
Think about it.
That's birddogs.com/drenched, promo code DRENCHED, and get your free tumbler with every order. Birddogs.com/drenched. You won't want to take them off.
You're never going to want to take them off.
Girls will have to wrestle them off.
Girls are going to have to rip your fucking slacks off.
Bye.
Goodbye. Welcome back to the show. What else we got, dude? What else? Shout out to the Cincinnati Bengals offensive line. Let's go.
Shout out to the Bengals. Shout out to the Muslims.
Shout out Bengals. Shout out Muslims. Shout out Cincinnati Reds staff, pitching staff.
Shout out motherfucking.
Shout out to the relief pitchers from the Cincinnati Reds. Navy
shout out
Seals.
McKeever. Shout out Billy Spud.
Shout out McKeever in war mode. Let's go. Let's get it.
Dude,
shout
how
out.
Fucking
shout out
funny.
Stuff. I got in a fight with O'Connor last night.
Did you really?
Yeah. Classic.
About what?
The exact same thing every single time.
What about like the steel dossier?
Admit you're
or
wrong. Yeah. I just came home drunk, just like, dude, admit you're wrong one time. He was like, he for real is a Tim Robinson character.
I can't
like,
do it.
I always admit when I'm wrong. I just can't think of it right now. Like it really is. Like, I tell you, I'm sorry, but I can't.
He's telling you, he's like, there's nothing in my head. I'm being honest with you, and there's nothing I'm wrong about. Sick. That's a kind of a sick move.
And he was drunk enough that I could fuck with him a little.
Yeah.
Like, I was acting like I was very upset with him.
Yeah.
And I was like, dude, think of one thing. I'm going to go upstairs and get something. Think of one thing you were wrong about. And when I get back, I want you to have it. And he was like, okay. Like he was taking it seriously. It was very fun.
That's a fucking horror show to think about.
What? Just
being hammered. There's two people hammering a thing. Yeah. Running psyops.
Yeah.
It's Very funny.
I think he's running a PSYOP.
You think he's?
I don't know if he's doing it intentional or not, but the second Biden won, he was like, I'm done with politics. I'm not going to pay attention to any of this.
Well, that's a calculated move, though.
It's a calculated move. He was the king of politics.
Yeah, he's into him.
He was the whole time.
Yeah.
Now he's like, you were the one who cared. I don't even think I ever thought about politics. I'm like, damn, O'Connor, I don't know if you're doing this on purpose, but if you are, you're a genius.
Yeah. I honestly think the more Biden falls, the more I appreciate him on it. At this point, he's on his fifth fucking fall.
Yeah.
I watched him fall the last time. I was like, this was a tough fall.
They reminded me of JFK.
Yeah.
The airport. The airport. Not that fall. He took a big tumble. He fell and got, I love the way Biden fell and got up and pointed.
That was nice, man.
Fuck was that?
The hell was going on right there?
Just blamed something on the ground immediately.
Yeah, it was the thing's fault.
Perhaps.
To be fair to him, if that thing wasn't there, he's like, who the fuck put a sandbag in my path?
Yeah.
But yeah, he's how many tumbles has he taken so far? Is that like fucking
documented
five?
A lot?
Yeah, yeah, true.
He must be falling all day.
Oh my god!
He must be riddled with bruises, dude.
Yeah, dude. He's at the
that age. That fall wasn't easy.
He can crack a femur.
That bike fall was fucking tough, dude. That was just straight to his side,
dude. What's the count at right now?
Counting falling up the steps?
The count right now is at least 8 since winning the 2020 election.
He says 8 public spills?
Yeah,
spilled 8 times.
Some website made an article. Four incidents have been up the stairs.
Up the stairs is tough.
On his way to the plane, on his way to the PJ.
Yeah, who among us hasn't fallen up the stairs?
That one I was like today, 3 actually. Up the stairs at once.
Oh, yeah. Really?
He just kept falling up the stairs.
Yeah. Maybe he's counting all of them.
Somebody must have gotten his ear and be like, dude, you got to display how fucking young and spry you are. So he always tries to like jog places. For a while, he was jogging.
Yeah, I've seen him do that before.
He jogs out. It's pretty nice. He comes out of the bullpen like rocker. Dude. Yeah, like sprints out. I'm about to mumble.
They must have like metal rods. They must have metal rods in his bones or something. Because
the way he's falling, you'd be damaged, dude.
Yeah, he's at the age where he can like break his leg.
Well, my grandma was his age. We've talked about it. She fell behind a bush trying to get her hose and just had to lay there for like 7 hours in the summer behind a bush.
Really?
In the mulch, just finally the neighbor kids got home from school and she was like, hello. They just saw an old, it was a witch, dude. Saw an old woman's head sticking out from a bush.
Oh my god, they probably thought like, the azaleas.
Don't go over there.
Yeah, dude.
She's going to eat us.
Oh, they probably thought like the azaleas were talking to her. Talking to them or whatever. That's fun. Yeah. That's terrifying. Boys.
He's geezed up.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
I told him last. I got to tell this. It makes me laugh every single time. Phil, she was living with us. She fell right at the front door. She was just on the ground next to our front door in like that side room. She was just laying on the floor. Phil had to move a couch in. So he asked the neighbor kid to carry it in with him.
Oh.
So the kid was carrying that end. Phil's walking it in. The kid goes in first and is like, oh my God. Like an old woman's just laying on the ground. Phil came in second. Was like, ah, Jesus Christ.
There was just a downed woman.
Just a downed woman. And you know how weird it is when you go into like your neighbor's house?
Yeah.
Like you just see this house every single day of your life. And then you finally get inside it and you're like, whoa.
Yeah, true.
I had no idea what this was.
Oh.
Then you see just a woman laying on the ground like, hello.
That'd be a nice Jones for a billionaire to have like to hit up retirement homes and be like, yeah, give me like 10 of them. Just have elderly ladies
laying around on the ground throughout.
That's kind of decadent. Just have like dying ladies. You feed them. You give them a good end of life. Like not quite hospice, but like just make sure that, you know, if they fall, they're down. It's like, that's it.
An interesting way to like hoard, like people hoard cats.
Oh.
You find like a dead cat under the couch.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, hoarding old ladies would be nice. Dude.
Yeah, old ladies like that have the life shelf of like, or the shelf life of like a fish you win at a carnival. You take home in a bag. You're like, I'm going to take care of this thing. 3 days later, you're like, fuck.
Shit.
Son of a bitch, it's gone.
These things die right away. It's crazy.
Yeah, they die. What the hell?
One of them with 15 years later is just huge. Like, what the fuck?
It's an 8-foot woman. This thing's not going anywhere.
Nobody believes you. Like, you didn't get her from the fucking home. Yeah. Get the fuck out of here.
Got her in third grade.
Dude, I swear to God, fucking my brother fed it every day.
That was funny, dude. Dudes get those fucking goldfish.
Oh my God.
10 years later, they got a fucking carp.
Dude, I don't think I ever took them out of the bag. I would get them from the fair and they'd be in a bag and I'd be like, nah.
I'd put it down. back to the Vidya games. I know. Hit pause, be like, oh shit, I left that thing out on the sidewalk.
Yeah, the water just boiled.
Yeah,
that is a shame. I want to get some hermit crabs going this summer.
Hermit crab, yeah, you got kids, they're gonna love those fucking
hermit
things.
Crabs would be nice.
Hermit crab, I wanted hermit crabs so fucking bad,
dude. I would come back and
my parents never got, my uncle got me one.
Did he really? Beast. What a fucking beast. Yeah, you come legend. Back I'd be like, it's gonna switch shells. I come back, it would switch. I'd be like, so mad I didn't see the switch happen. I was like, fuck.
I'd love to see the switch.
Yeah, I mean, dude, when you get the hermit crab, when they come damn near all the way out of their shell, that's exciting.
I was always kind of scared of them.
Yeah, I mean, they could pinch you.
I was scared of the hermit crabs.
I remember
being a kid and being like,
dude, I know guys who fucked around with like the big ass hermit. I always stayed with little
guys.
Yeah,
the fucking thick
claw. The real pincher, dude.
Yeah.
I've never got pinched by a hermit crab.
I have not either, and that's because I was extremely cautious around those.
So was I.
I was really cautious.
I got them little enough where they could walk around in your hand and stuff.
Yeah.
And you feel them feeling around, but my older cousins would have the fucking big boys. And I'm like, man, you got to be kidding me.
That's so fun.
How long, what's a hermit crab's lifespan? Because I'm going to see if I can keep one alive and keep switching it up. Get that thing into a fucking conch.
Still got that bonsai tree?
Yeah. It's on my roof deck. Swear to God. It's on my roof deck.
Is that thing still alive?
It's hibernating right now.
No, you can't do a hermit crab. You can't do a bonsai.
Yeah, right.
Hermit crab. Bonsai is like 500 years.
Dude, no way. Those things are so hard. Dude, let me tell you a little story about that bonsai tree.
That was a symbol of our friendship. Dude.
I know, but here's
you
the thing.
You let it die?
I tried my fucking best.
I know.
So here's what happened. That thing that was not meant for indoors. The company that sold that was a Chinese elm. So that thing was meant for like chillier temperatures. So I'm like, it's in my house. It starts shedding like fucking crazy. There's a deeper meaning in this story.
You could have thrown this thing out.
Dude, I was fucking watering it, doing all the stuff. The leaves kept falling off. I was like, fuck. Apparently the soil, if you get a bonsai, the soil they give it to you in is bullshit. They give you like fucking nonsense soil. So then I'm fucking freaking out. I'm putting it in this window, The leaves keep falling out. Finally, I just put it outside. Dude, the thing just flourished, bounced back. Did all this research that said Chinese elms can take the frost. It's perfect. So it was flourishing, and then and like winter came.
Summertime, it chills.
Leaves fell. No, it fucking, no, dude, this thing's dead. But then,
you just kept it.
But here's the deeper story is the elm, when I was doing everything I could, and it was just, the stuff was falling, I let it out to the elements. And it flourished, and then it died.
Oh, that's all right. Everything dies.
Well, the winter time, I think they'd snap it out. But yeah, if you get a bonsai, man, get it out of that plant immediately. Then you have to replant them in the spring.
Yeah,
you can't just replant them.
When I bought it for you, and then it came with like a full like course on how to maintain it, and I was like, maybe this is some shit Matt would like.
I love bonsai trees, but I love the idea of them.
That's a lot of work.
So much fucking
work.
Even
learning anything about a fucking plant.
My thing is, the problem with it is like, you can experiment with different plants, and if it dies, it dies. The bonsai is such a high ticket item.
Yeah.
I was freaking out trying to fucking do it. And I was like, all right, I'm going to transplant it. And they're like, you got to transplant it in the spring. It'll die. And I'm like, fuck. I was panicking for
a month.
Well,
I appreciate you putting in that effort.
I was panicking for a month. But yeah, the funny story is like, I did have that bonsai ready to tell a story about it. And be like, yeah, and I put it out and it flourished. Now, where's it now? Like, it's dead.
It did die, but.
But, dude, that was, for me, I was like, that was cool. And I put it outside and it just started budding. I was like.
You just strike me as a bonsai guy.
I am a bonsai guy.
I got the perfect gift.
I am a bonsai. I was talking to Brittany.
Nobody buys a bonsai tree for a friend.
Nobody.
I was like, I got fucking Spud, the Lord of the Rings axe.
Yep.
Billy, the autographed Trump.
Yep.
Bonsai tree.
You were right. You were Lemaire. Absolutely right.
What would you get Lemaire? If you could get it. A man who has everything.
Let me see. I mean, it would be definitely...
The brand new edition of Street Fighter would have been nice.
He got it already. He's got everything. Yeah, he's got fucking everything. I would get Lemaire.
Oh, I'm going to get you a Steam Deck right now. Oh. You can have it.
Oh.
You want that Steam Deck?
Oh, do I have to lift 265? I fucking crush it.
You have to lift 265 in the Steam Deck. I was thinking getting him like a very high-end girlfriend experience.
That's pretty good.
Like a weekend long girlfriend.
A weekend
experience.
Prostitute.
Yeah.
But like a good one. Who's your favorite porn star?
Right now,
ooh, Mini Stallion. You knew the answer like and then you got right afraid.
Mini Stallion?
Mini Stallion?
Mini Stallion. Yeah, and it, yeah, she's like 4'10". And there's also another girl named I'm XXX Dark. She's what? The best. Well, her name's I'm...
Let me say.
Oh, no, dude, that's man. A girl.
No, that's a woman. That's a woman, dude.
She's 4'10"?
Her name's Mini Stallion?
Mini Stallion, yeah, like a little horse.
She's not legal, man.
That's a queen, dude.
Mini Stallion.
She's a true queen.
Oh, brother.
Oh, my God.
Matt looked at porn.
I've seen porn. Honestly, I'll be honest, dude. It hasn't. It doesn't have the grip on me. I feared it was going to have.
That's all I've ever wanted for you, Matt.
No, it has, doesn't have that.
Dude, that's.
Let me say. That's fucking awesome.
Shout out, Mini Stallion. They keep putting her with giant dudes, though, I think.
She doesn't.
She's got cum in her butt.
You went too far. Yeah, you swept too far.
She's a collab independent, so she does it. She's not her own.
I don't know what you just said.
She collaborates and she's independent, so she's putting out her own mixtapes, dude.
Yeah. So she's hunting down.
Yeah. Yeah. She knows what she's about.
She's Captain Ahab.
Yeah, it's Cap, dude. It's Cap.
You wanna see what I was looking at?
Yeah.
I was looking at some Mini Stallions myself today.
Damn, dude.
How nice is that?
That's awesome. Real Shetlands.
That's Mini Stallions.
That's the only Mini Stallions.
That's Mini Stallions,
yeah, that's
dude.
The real
one. Not watching some black midget get cum in her ass.
But yeah, no, dude. The experiment was I wanted to do a year off, and then I was like, all right, now I'm back on. I mean, obviously, my will did finally collapse.
You seem chill, dude. You got the tie dye. You seem a lot chiller now that you're back on the nog, dude.
Dude, it's like period duty. If I know it's out of my gets for like, I'm like, oh, I have a solid week, nothing I can do.
Yeah.
I've been using it for that, but I have what I was worried about has become like a nightly ritual. It's not at all. I hit the nog once, maybe twice, and then I go, I need the real deal.
I had a nice one.
Now I have a weird ratio where I can't nog out too much. I need to have the real deal between. Otherwise, I'll go back into
real
nog
deal one. Like sexual intercourse?
Yeah.
Real yes. deal.
Pussy.
Physical encounters.
Physical, the touch.
Mutual petting.
My touch. Kissing.
Kissing. Stroking.
I'm due too.
Fingering.
I got a fucking. It's in the bank right now.
What, you're owed some pussy pie?
I'm owed some motherfucker.
Obviously, you're just feeling it special. Exactly. You deserve a sweet slice. Sweet slice of wife pie.
Yeah,
the classic pie. Wife pie.
True. I rest knowing it's coming. It could be any night. It could be any night. It could be tomorrow. I don't know. But it's definitely, it's literally.
It could happen at any moment.
Can't fucking.
That is nice. The anticipation.
Well, dude, this is another thing too. I will say, because again, I'm coming at it from a functional perspective. I mean, you know, obviously I did come at it from a moral perspective as well. But dude, it was like, I was coming so fast. I finally have sex with my sweet wife and it was just like every single time.
From not
I was on a basically like,
yeah, of course, dude.
I was barely fapping. When it comes to like using your imagination, you're just like, I'll wait. After a while, you're like, I'll wait.
Yeah.
And then it's like, next thing you know, it's so sorry.
How did I forget this?
What?
In the hotel in Indianapolis, check in. I'm like, I'm gonna jack off.
Yeah.
I'm in there naked on top of the made bed. Fully naked. I was about to get in the shower.
Yeah.
Cracked open the lotion. I'm laying there. Phone like this. Dude. A dude just opens the door. A dude just walks in.
What?
And,
did he feast his eyes?
And took him a long time to avert his eyes. His
what?
Gaze was on my body. And I also didn't.
He froze.
I didn't move. I just was like. dude, what are you doing? Like, I didn't, there was no shame. I was just like, what the fuck are you doing? And he's like, oh, I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry. I said, my life, my rules. It was crazy. He was like, no one's supposed to be in here. I was like, well, I'm in here and I'm fucking jacking off. I haven't been caught whacking off in so long. I didn't give a fuck. I thought, dude, I would be. I thought I'd be mortified.
It was,
I
almost a lady. How was it not a lady?
A lady, I think, might have been worse.
You think so?
That would have been a little shameful.
I mean,
I don't know why. I think, dude, I just saw an Indian guy's face. And he did it maybe because of the light. Maybe because it was dark in my room and it took him a second to get adjusted because he was like,
no way, dude. He was just feasting
for
his
real,
eyes.
He feasted his eyes. I mean, it must have looked nuts. I was on top of a white, you were, all white bed. I was I was like an octopi.
He might not have seen you, dude.
Yeah, I don't think he saw me because he stood there for a minute like, hello? I was like, what are you, dude?
It's like Beauty and the Beast. Well, the furniture
like
started talking.
This far away.
Really?
So close.
What?
Dude. What? He opened the front door. It was like,
he definitely saw you fapping on the bed.
He saw me rock hard, too. As hard as it gets, dude. Maybe that's why I was not ashamed. If he would have got me early,
yeah,
lotioning up,
working
a pud,
up a soft bird,
working a pud with lotion.
Fuck you! Get the fuck out of here,
dude.
Yeah, that's the best
I was
thing ever.
I laughed. He heard me laughing. He was like, "Don't tell anyone." I was like, "I'm not gonna tell anyone."
What the fuck? What's it? Why
he's
is he
get fucking fired?
Oh, yeah.
If I went down to the desk and I was like, what the fuck was
he
that?
He walked in on me masturbating.
I was in there masturbating.
I was rock fucking hard. I was about to come.
I had a boner. By the way, right back to work.
Of course, dude.
Put the hard hat back on.
Of course. I mean, at that point, it's like, whatever.
It did lower my penis.
You think it knocked
it
down?
Work, I had to work it back up.
Well, I mean, what's that worth in terms of what's that worth in terms of a hotel? Be like, dude, he ruined my fucking boner.
He ruined a boner, but that day actually made things better. Getting hard twice in one session.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
Okay, let's go. So, shout out to that guy who witnessed.
He froze.
I mean, the abominable snowman was laying down. The fucking Yeti was whacking off, dude. Dude, I was all right, laying flat on a fully made hotel bed. I must have looked huge, dude. In the dark, your eyes are adjusting. He was like, what the fuck is that? No one's supposed to be in here.
What the fuck?
What are you doing? He's like, oh.
Dude.
I'm sorry.
God damn.
And then he knocked. He waited. He went outside, closed the door, waited like 20 seconds, and then knocked. And I was like, dude, you know what I'm doing.
You know I'm
jerking. You know I'm ass naked jerking off. And he was like, I have your amenities. I was like,
fucking,
leave them at the fucking door.
Yeah, dude.
What do you think?
Were you still? So you had to talk.
Yeah, I had to stand up rock hard with a lotion to boner at the hotel, talking through a door. Like,
no man should ever have to do that.
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
That's crazy.
It's a wild day.
Yeah.
And then.
Your ass was all sweaty.
It was like a cardboard box with like M&Ms.
Yeah.
And just shit in your hotel room.
God damn, dude.
It was not a dire mission.
They got to stop playing and start breaking dudes off with auto blows in there.
They walk in every time. I stay at hotels every single weekend. Somebody walks into my room.
Really?
Yeah, it I guess I forget to put that. I got to start putting up the thing. Every morning I wake
put
up.
Put a sock
to somebody,
on your door.
I
put a sock on your door.
I wake up every morning to somebody walking in.
I never get
sorry. I wake up every day to I'm sorry.
Oh man, I always wish I never get that.
Yeah,
I just want to like just be laying there, blanket down
awake,
here.
You're awake before.
Yeah, I'm up early. Yeah, I'm up early. I'm up early. True.
I'm asleep.
I also when I see them, I'm like, just don't worry about my
room.
It's
like 11 a.m. They come in.
Yeah, I'm up.
I'm still like,
dude, that must have been such a kingly sight, dude. You on that bed,
naked. On a fully made, perfect bed.
You were total no clothes whatsoever.
I was knees locked. I was as long as I could be. I must have looked 6'8".
Oh, my. How big was the dude?
He was just a younger, chubby Indian man.
God, he probably wrote a letter to his parents.
Yeah.
Parents today, in Bombay. He's like, today I saw a large
man. I saw the biggest man I have ever seen. I believe he was masturbating.
Dude, it sounded like he yelled. Wanted to, like, suck your dick.
How long
dude.
Do you think it took?
He did not want to suck my dick.
What? I don't know, man. He was staring.
He was frozen, dude.
In the gutter, dude. He witnessed the power. He was frozen.
He's probably frozen, dude. That's a fright, like a what?
It's a jarring.
Fight, fright, or flee, or freeze, or whatever.
Yeah, fright or freeze.
Fight, flight, or freeze. Fight, flight, or freeze.
Yeah, it was. It was. He probably had the Saving Private Ryan fucking buzzing in his ear.
Yeah.
He heard me like, God.
God. What the fuck are you doing? Get the fuck out of here. We gotta get off this beach.
Yes, sir. My life.
He might have been ready. He might have been a cowboy. He'd been like, you need something to come into, sir. Sir, you need a doll to come into?
Yeah, I would have accepted that.
Cowboy?
Just a very nightly. Yeah.
Just running out like a tennis match.
Just a
like,
catcher. Yeah. Sprint back. Just sit on the side of your bed. Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, it must have been nasty, dude, when people had servants like that. You just get up and fucking just
yeah.
Clean that up.
Clean up the fucking jizz.
Clean up my fucking jizz. Because people probably didn't have much shame around that back then.
Yeah.
Clean my fucking jizz. Like pre-Christian Europe. I was laughing. I don't know why. I can't get this image out of my head of people in like Ireland or England. Just like two fucking shitty dudes just like pushing each other over a fence line. Being like, this is mine. Fucking yard. Just,
yeah. Yeah.
One of your sons would come out and like punch the other guy shillelagh. In the side.
Just a club.
You fucking killed him. Yeah. He's trying to push our rocks over. It's a rock fence. You'd finish, you get tired, and go back in and be like, that was a fucking sick day.
That's nice.
Yeah. I like to think about
this
that.
This is good stuff.
I like to think about dudes in 1200 fucking pushing each other. Just fucking.
Yeah. Just disputes for nothing. That throughout time have been complete. They were useless then.
Yeah.
And to look back 1,000 years later and be like,
you fucking idiots. Yeah.
It's just dogs barking at each other, dude.
True.
That's all we are.
Gardino, what are we looking at?
Yeah. Oh my God. Let's take a little hiatus, get some UFC going, and then jump right into the Patreon.
That's what we're
going
to go.
Thank you for listening. Oh, do you want to do that lift real quick before the Patreon? You want to do it after or before?
After.
You're not ready right now.
I can do it now.
What do you want to do, Matthew? I know you have to do another.
I'm going to do stuff after this. Because
we were going to do it while you were doing stuff, but if you want to be a part of it.
Well, I don't. I mean, I'll go now. I'm not doing stuff till 5.
All right.
So.
All right. We'll see. What a cliffhanger.
Yeah, for sure. True. Ooh.
Goodbye.
Yeah, let's do it.